The focus of my talk will be on MIPAR, which I presented yesterday, a science gateway for analyzing and sharing medical images. The focus today will be more of the impact we're expecting from MIPAR and the impact of Sci-GaIA, but I will still give some information about MIPAR just for the sake of those who were not here yesterday. The background. Medical images are images acquired from humans, so and they are used for humans or animals, you know, any living thing. If you acquire images from them, so they could be seen as medical images. And why do you need to do that? They are useful for medical diagnostics, for treatment, and for patient management. And the thing is, there are different kinds of images depending on what you are looking or you want to look at, you know, and each of the technique has its own strength, area of use, and weaknesses. But there is always a need to get information from the images acquired. So typically what happens is, like if we take X-ray image as an example, if you have X-ray image, the radiologist just looks at it and then is able to say some things about what is happening in that part of the body. But sometimes we need to process to get better information. And so the field of computer vision and medical image analysis gives us the platform to develop computational techniques. Sometimes the images, the way they come, they are raw images. So they have to be processed to make them in a way that it will make sense to humans. So the ability to extract information from images, medical images, to make them meaningful is very, very important. And that is one of the, you know, the benefits of medical image analysis and computer vision. Now, in terms of image analysis in Africa, we have some challenges in Africa. One is the equipment for imaging, they are quite expensive. You know, some, they range from very cheap one to very expensive one, but those that are very, very important are not cheap to come by. You know, like I always like to use the example of an MRI scanner. You know, if you're thinking about MRI scanner, you know, and you think about the magnetic strength, 1.5 is the least that is allowed in, you know, for research now. And that will be about £1 million. So that's not very cheap. But that will give you the beautiful image that you need, so diagnosis could be done easily without any problem. So because this is expensive, that means that anywhere we have them, you know, using them, we need to come with a price tag. And so it could be very expensive to acquire images from them. And there are limited, you know, medical image analysts, you know, in this part of the world. So we're just trying to see how we can start, although we started training people. So, but there is need to grow, you know, in terms of capacity for medical image analysts. You know, but there is limited, again, in terms of limitation in terms of collaboration efforts, not only among clinicians. It's just a general problem. And that is why open science is quite, you know, a key thing for us in this part of the world. So we do not collaborate enough. Everybody seems to protect its own domain, you know, rather than coming together and working together, solving the common problems. So most of the scientific problems are common problems. So we, the field of open science, we, or science gateway, will help us to be able to collaborate and to be able to solve our problems even better. Now, Science Gateway provides a solution. So there is a way out of the problems I've atomized, you know. The advancements in terms of, in the area of data communication and internet technology, plus the fact that hardware cost goes down with time, has created the platform for, you know, or has given birth to Science Gateway. And with Science Gateway, it is actually possible for you, as we've been hearing from various talks, you know, for you to have, you know, process your data at a remote end with one powerful machine somewhere that you do not even know the location, but through a web interface, you can have access to any tool, you know. So with that, it is possible for us to create repositories. It's possible for us to offer software, you know, as a service, and it's even possible for us to offer, you know, platform as a service. You know, all these are, you know, available through Science Gateway. So we try to, you know, take advantage of this and then develop something that could be useful for Africa. You know, Science Gateway is moving in the developed world, but we are struggling in this part of the world. So the aim of the project was to develop an e-infrastructure that will serve as a repository and an image processor. So two in one. So it will be a repository and an image processor. So if you think about repository, yes, we create a database, you know, we are able to access the data. So that doesn't seem to be very big. We all have access to repositories. But now having a processing power at the back end is not quite easy. So there is need to use some new technologies to do that. So that was our target. And the idea is that there will be benefits coming with this. You know, since we're talking about medical science, so we think that this could improve, you know, diagnosis in terms of the accuracy and even timeliness, you know. So when you have access to images, you know more about it, you get more acquainted into it, and you have a platform that allows you to talk to experts and share knowledge, so diagnosis could be better, and improve patient management, you know. Life expectancy can improve if we get diagnosis done on time, you know, and then some we can live longer. You know, some of us have to travel to the West to get diagnosis sometimes. But if we have all these, and images could be uploaded from anywhere, and we could get expertise of opinion. So I did mention here that it saves cost of traveling. So that's just to help us see how this relates to the field, of telemedicine. You know, so you don't need necessarily have to travel because you want to chat with an expert in that field. So you may not be a surgeon, and you need the service of a surgeon. But if you can upload your image somewhere where the surgeon can have access to it, then you can discuss and advice could be given. Now, there are some activities that we've engaged in, you know, in trying to achieve our aim, which was to develop a repository and a processor in the area of, you know, image, medical images. So the first thing we did, luckily, we got a call through Echo Connect about this summer hackfest in Catania. And so we attended the training, you know, because it's been in my mind for several years to thinking about how to develop a tool like this, but how to do it, because that's not my field. So it was a struggle. So I keyed into it and I applied, you know, for the training. So I attended the training in Catania in July last year, and that's where we started the development of MIPAR. And so we progress. We all know that software development, you know, you can't just do within 2 weeks if you are doing something good. So we continued. In Tanzania, we presented the progress. And then in Nigeria, during the Hackfest, we were able to extend MIPAR. You know, what we had in MIPAR before the Hackfest in Nigeria, we could, users could donate, could download, but there was no element of the analysis, you know, data analysis in it. So we did a little bit of extension in Lagos, and we presented the complete package. Or we finished the development in December last year. So the first presentation that shows the complete development was made in Kenya this year, February. And I want to say that all through these activities, we've benefited from the help of Sci-GaIA. So what is MIPAR? For the sake of those who were not here yesterday. So MIPAR simply means Medical Image Processor and Repository. So it's an e-infrastructure that allows you to share and analyze or process your images. So that's the URL in case you want to visit it, and my contact details is there in case you want to give us images or you want to collaborate with us. But that's what MIPAR does. It allows you to share and to process medical images. So who are the audience that we're targeting? So four categories I put here. So we're thinking about clinicians. Clinicians may need to look at their images or images of patients. And then researchers. So researchers want to, you know, like scientists, we always need data. So you have a brilliant idea of how to process or how to do a research, but you do not have data. So on MIPAR, you will get free data, and you could start to do your science. You know, so you could be MSc, PhD, or faculty members. anyone interested in analyzing medical images. So if your interest is around medical images, whatever the kind of image, as long as it's acquired from humans or animals, then our thought is that you might need our tool. Anyone interested in collaborating with us or with analysts, because the idea is that many people will have access to the portal, so there will be a forum for people to chat. So what can users do with MIPAR? Now you know who can use it. So, but what can you do with MIPAR? So you can donate images. So donation means we don't pay you for that, so it has to be free. And you can download freely as well. So whatever we have from MIPAR, you know, people can get for free. And you can process your images, analyze them, or discuss a case report. So sometimes diagnosis requires a teamwork. And so you might want another expert, as I said before, to actually give an opinion about a particular image. So on MIPAR, this could be achieved. Now, I gave a sample here of, image processing in the context of brain MRI. So we call this one anatomical image. So very clean image, T1 weighted. And so what we have done here, just two processes. From the leftmost to the middle image, we have removed, the non-brain, the non-brain part of human brain, of humans, of the entire image. So what we don't need, we have removed. So the skull and the scalp are gone. And now the rightmost is a segmentation procedure or process has happened. So segmentation is we partition the brain based on, in this kind of segmentation, this is called tissue segmentation. So what we have done is to focus on a particular tissue. So we call this one white matter. I color-coded it just to show that we have the left and the right, and we have all the different lobes. So but why is white matter very interesting? White matter, part of the brain, is that part of the brain that connects the cortical regions, the cortex, those areas that handle, thinking, most of the things that the brain does. So the white matter, tissue does the connection. So the fibers, they are all in white matter. And this is very important. So it might be that is all that, a researcher is interested in. So but with MIPAR, you can do that and you can quantify, this white matter. And it's got implications. For example, white matter has been found to be associated with stroke. So people who have stroke, it could be that the fibers are not well connected. So this is very, very important. And this is not the only part of tissue. So we can have the gray matter, we can have the CSF and others. So what can users do with MIPAR? I've mentioned about you can donate, you can process, you can download, and you can actually look at the output. So the first 1, 2, 3, 4, the first four activities were done before the Lagos ACFest. So the extension, what we did in Lagos, during the Lagos ACFest, was to introduce the analyzed image. So I just put there, the types of images, this our target, but for the time being, we've only tested on MRI and brain. So, but we're thinking of different anatomies and the image formats at the current time, that's it. But that will increase over time. And in terms of processing, all we've got on MIPAR at the current time is brain images. But I have some PhD and MSc students working on CT scan, working on ultrasound, and working on X-ray. So once those, we finish developing those, so we just put them in on MIPAR. So the modules, registration is the first thing, but you do not need to register, to use MIPAR. You do not need to register on MIPAR. All you need is federated identity. So once you have the login details through federation identity, you can use MIPAR to do all the kind of things that MIPAR does. So user requirements. So what do you need in case you want to use MIPAR? So software requirements, a web browser, internet, the operating system, and that's it, as long as you have federated login. And the hardware requirement, just simple system is enough. So you don't need a massive RAM because the system that does all the processing is at remote end. So impact of MIPAR. So these are our targets. Data availability, So we want data to be available for people in terms of medical images. And you know that the fact that data is available does not mean it's shareable. So shareability is another one. And we believe strongly that this will encourage collaboration. In fact, during the meeting in Kenya, I was able to talk to some people in Uganda who have promised to actually donate data to us. So that is, in a way, encouraging collaboration, reproducibility. Yes, because the tools at the back end of MIPAR are standard image processing tools. So if you process your image and others can try at using the same tool, these are standard medical images, so you can reproduce without any problem because we're on the same platform, standardization. So that gives us the opportunity to use the same tool for all kinds of images. Educational benefits, yes, MIPAR, the source code is available, or freely online. So we believe that people can learn from it and then develop something similar in future. So improved diagnosis and patient management, I've mentioned that already. So that's the home page of MIPAR, and that's the URL. So feel free to visit it. So in case you want to use MIPAR, I said previously that you need federated identity. So there will be an organization that you are affiliated with among those working for West Africa. Now, if none of the organizations, if you do not have affiliation with any of the organizations, or you are not registered with any of them, if you use casual, that could probably be sufficient. And then once you click on casual, then you have the ID open for the general one, and all the organizations which you are affiliated with, you can just click on any of them, and then you will have access to MIPAR. So once access is granted, now you can do the donation, you can download, you can process, you can do all kinds of things. So this is just the donation module. So if you want to donate images, to us through MIPAR, so you just select the donate image menu, and that gives you the opportunity to choose the type of image, the anatomy, that is the body part, and then you can select the images you want to donate. We want all images to come as to be compressed, and so they come as GZ, so you have to compress your images or zip it, and then you are able to click donate, and the images are received by us. And then because at the back end we are using open access repository, so MIPAR is connected with OAR, so images are received and stored on OAR. So, but you won't see OAR, you won't see, that because everything is, all access is through MIPAR. So, but for every image you submitted to us, DOI is actually allocated automatically. So you don't have to do that. So image search and download. So now we know how to donate. So the second thing is, in case you want to download images, so you want to do research or you want to just play with some images, medical images. So now you click on the download images, and then you have the opportunity to, very similar to the upload or to the donation. So you can select the type of image and the anatomy, and you can browse. So once you click the browse, so it queries everything we have, and it gives a list of what is available that is relevant to the key that you have submitted, the search key. And now you can download the images for free. So this is just a display tool for us to use for visualization of brain images. Though this is not available on MIPAR, but it's a free software. Everything is free. So you download this and put it on your local machine, and it's a very small piece of software, but can allow you to see a clean 3D image. So this is a 3D brain MRI image showing the axia, which is the topmost left, and you have the sagittal, which is the rightmost, and then you have the one at the bottom, which is, that's the corona, is the top left, corona, top left, then sagittal, right, and you have the axia, which is the one in the bottom. So that just allows you to see a 3D image. So it's for visualization, MRI Crow, that's the name of the software. Okay, so this is for processing. So if you want to process, it's just like you want to request a service. So you need to have the data you want to process, though you can process data that is available on MIPAR as well. But we assume that you have your data and you want to process. So what do you need to do? you need to know what kind of process. So you need the service of somebody or a professional. You need to know the service that you require. So you need to select the kind of processes you want to do, and then you submit your image, and MIPAR will do the processing and make the output available for you to download. We keep the output, I think, for 24 hours, so you are required to download the processed image, because we don't want to run out of this space at the at the back end. So once your images are processed, you can see the output, so you download, because automatically they will be deleted from the server after 24 hours. So just to show that brain extraction has happened there, I showed us a slide on that, but that was a 2D slide image. So this is 3D of a brain extracted image. So the analyze model, simple, very simple statistics. So using R, so you can perform regression, compute correlation, compare two groups within a data set, or compare two measurements. So all these are things we do. If you want to compare a clinical group with a control group, so that can be done, and we know we need statistics. That's why we included statistics there, so that we can make MIPAR a little bit smart. Now, what are our future plans? Yes, MIPAR is ready and it's available to everybody, but we want to spread the good news, let people know about MIPAR, and we need to get data, So we have only tiny, data on MIPAR at the moment, so we want to solicit, for data. In case you have data, or you know somebody who has, brain or medical images, then please contact us. MIPAR has only been tested on brain MRI images, but all that will be included. So in trying to conclude, MIPAR can allow you to share, process, and analyze medical images. Impact of Sci-GaIA on MIPAR. So from MIPAR, we benefited from specialized training on open science technology. So two trainings we have attended, one in Catania in July, and the other one in Lagos. That was in November last year. And then software development support, yes. Sci-GaIA team has been extremely supportive. So anytime we needed help, even when we're not there together physically, we always get help. And I want to really appreciate the team for the good work. Funding for participants to attend meetings to present use cases. So we benefited, from training, presenting, and attending meetings. Everything has been sponsored by Sci-GaIA. So we're really, really indebted to Sci-GaIA. And finally, the hardware and software resources. Yes, the server. Currently, MIPAR is being hosted in the University of Catania. Though there is a plan to move it to Africa, but we have benefited from that, because if there is no place to host, then there is no way we can make the resource available to people. So WACREN and EcoConnect are actually working hard to get us, a server where we can host MIPAR in Nigeria. So we have our dedicated software on the server, but we have the other software that drives, open science technology that were provided by Sci-GaIA. So we really, really appreciate Sci-GaIA. So appreciations to all the team members, Roberto, Simon, Bruce, and all those people who have supported us to make sure that this is become a fruitful journey. Thank you very much for listening.